Since the 1980s, Denmark has supported the Bandim project in Guinea-Bissau with 50 million Danish kroner to research and research capacity development. What has Denmark gained from that money?
I hope they have gained a lot. It's a lot of money, but it's over a very long period. One of the most spectacular things we have done was that in late 1989, WHO recommended a new measles vaccine, and we showed first in Guinea-Bissau and later in Senegal that this vaccine was associated with 2 times higher female mortality. And it had become official policy to use this vaccine, but we were able to show that the vaccine was associated with higher female mortality, and it was later confirmed both in Sudan and on Haiti. And if the vaccine had been generally implemented as was planned, then it would have cost at least 500,000 female death additionally in Africa.
In terms of research capacity development, what has been the results of the Bandim project in Guinea-Bissau? In other African and Asian countries, and also in Denmark?
We have contributed importantly to sort of the research training, and we have also had, since it has been primarily a Danish project, we've had a lot of Danish students, medical students coming out and working in the study area, and have learned sort of the basic of living conditions in low-income countries and the health conditions. But in general, we have also, the fact that we have sort of pursued that have followed the same population over a long time, we've been able to see changes that no one had planned to see. A basic contradiction is that research is to explain what you don't understand. But research training now is that you should only see what you have planned to see. That is essentially saying you don't want to see these strange things. But that's precisely what you can do if you follow the population over time. You can see things you hadn't planned to see, and that's the most fruitful in terms of gaining new knowledge.